Bob Balian from Bayside Church, and my prayer is that you're healthy and happy, and I just pray that there's some sense of normalcy in your life right now. I want to talk about something, and I want to start off by talking about my past Wednesday. This past Wednesday might have been the worst day in the history of the NBA. I'm not over-exaggerating. A lot of things have happened with Kobe's death and David Stern's death, but this past Wednesday in the morning, I was with my small group, and one of my small group participants is my boss with the Sacramento Kings. His name is Galen Duncan. We happened to be talking about the fact that the NBA could be stopping crowds from coming in, and so we started talking about the ramifications of that. And Galen started telling us that a lot of the employees might get cut real soon if that happened. Concession stand employees, ticket sales people, other various outside of the basketball ops workers. And then I started thinking about myself getting selfish, and I was like, well, Galen, surely the man of God with the Sacramento Kings is going to come back and do chapel for all the games. And Galen looked at me. He said, Bob, you might be the most non-essential guy in the entire organization. Now, I recovered from that after a little while. Finished my day at work and went back to the arena to do chapel that night. It was the Kings against the Pelicans. And when I went into the chapel room to do chapel, they were still in the middle of a press conference. We found out, indeed, the commissioner had canceled the season. And so I happened to be right in front of Galen at that time again. I said, Galen, look who's non-essential now. All of y'all got to go home now. Well, I'm a firm believer that God gets more done in times of uncertainty with us than he ever does in the good times with us. I think he has our attention in times of uncertainty. So I think this is going to be a time of restoration and reformation for the church right now. I really do. Now that's not to take away the calamity and some of the tragedy that's going to happen, but at the same time, I think the church is going to use this, and God's going to use the church and use this opportunity. So how do we stay encouraged during times of crisis like this? Philippians chapter 4, I'm going to start at verse 4. I'm going to read you a few verses. This is what Paul says. Some of what he says here is enough to make you angry if you didn't know how much Paul had been through. When you know how much Paul had been through, then this starts applying to you. So verse 4 in chapter 4, rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say rejoice. Let your reasonableness be known to everyone. The Lord is at hand. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. This scripture we can really apply to our lives right now. And I think about a time when God had used a crisis to reveal himself to people. I think about Captain Sullenberger landing that U.S. Airways plane in the Hudson Bay 11 years ago. One news channel asked his lead flight attendant, what were the people doing as they prepared to crash land? And she said, I looked down the body of the plane and every single person had their heads bowed and they looked like they were praying. And I thought, you're dang skimpy they were praying. Because when we are prepared to crash land, we get really holy. We get really spiritual. And I think, again, God can use this right now. And I think God will use this. So what do we do now? I think it's we encourage one another. I think we be the church, even if we have to be the church online, even if we have to be the church individually by making calls to people and delivering goods and services to people. We go out and we be the church. And I think the second thing is he said their prayer and supplication. And I think we need to pray, not to the point where we get our prayers answered, because for some prayers, they might not get answered. If we're praying, hey, God, get this over with, it may take a while before this gets over with. But I think if we pray until we get peace, I think we can handle any circumstances. So someone asks you, Bob, you look great. You just got off an airplane. It must have been an awesome flight. Well, no, it was a terrible flight. Matter of fact, we had to land in the Hudson Bay. But I've got a peace that goes beyond human comprehension. And because of that, my circumstances aren't going to alter my peace. That's my prayer for you, is a peace that goes beyond human comprehension that Paul talks about in Philippians 4. That's all we need to get through this. We're going to get through this. It's going to be a day we can look back and say, thank you, Lord. That day's coming. But for now, let's be his light and his salt in a world that needs it. God bless you. We'll see you soon.